I have no clue. What's gonna happen now? Yes! Did you see that? Oh, yes! Hi everyone, in this episode we are going to defy gravity. This gear that you see in front of you here has a secret inside. If we remove the first layer of plywood, you see these round little pockets. These are places for disc magnets. So this gear will make two tasks for the price of one part. The gear will make sure that the programming wheel goes in a good speed, but it will also lift the marbles. And here you can see the system we had on the first machine. Everything was handmade, even those timing belt gear wheels was hand sawed on the bandsaw. And I was drilling and nailing millions of nails manually into these wooden blocks. Every nail was like manually put in there, and the marbles could ride on these small blocks that I put on this timing belt, and the blocks were going round and round, and the idea was to lift marbles up this way. It looks super cool, and it's a super stupid idea. So here you can see some of the problems. In the video we choose clips where it looks like it works good, but we had so much issues. If you see here, the marbles are like sprouting everywhere. There it picked up more marbles, and there it didn't pick up any marbles at all. And you see here it is chaos. So the marbles are flying everywhere, and here everything gets stuck and it's just a mess. Take a look at the top right corner right here. So do you see the metal bending? And I think it gets stuck. Yeah, it gets stuck again there. And if you look at the floor, the marbles are running all over the floor. We had to make something better for the Marble Machine X. So I have been very inspired by some fantastic YouTube channels that have built marble machines, and I want to show you this video from Ronald Walters, and I would really recommend you to check out Ronald Walters' channel because it's a fantastic channel. And when I saw this marble machine with the ring gear lift figure 8 transfer, I was amazed, because you can see here in the bottom how the marbles goes in, and Ronald has tilted this gear so gravity is holding them in place. And at the top they're changing to the second wheel. And this is Matthias Wandels Marble Machine 2.1. Also check out Matthias Wandels YouTube channel. It's amazing. So Ronald Walters and Matthias Wandel, thanks for the inspiration. So we started to make a prototype, and it's Karin and Olof who built this prototype. And we had a problem that Matthias and Ronald didn't have. We needed to lift 8 marbles per crank turn, because we realized that the machine needs to be able to play 8 marbles per crank turn. And we quickly realized that the hole solution that you just saw was not fast enough. So we went over to a magnet solution. And that was to increase the speed in which we could lift marbles per crank turn. So we had this measurement, marbles per crank turn, and the goal was 8. So here you can see the initial tests with the magnets and trying to rake the marbles off on the top with this 3D printed wedge here. Karin and Olof got this prototype to work really well. And we were also trying to figure out the maximum speed. And we could clearly see that this solution would easily be able to lift 8 marbles per crank turn.
Okay, där har vi väl ändå fått liksom. Nu har vi, ja.
I'm so excited. This package has been on its way to me for a long time, and yes! Magnets. Check that out.
Boom! So, this is where the magnets are supposed to go. It's already wanna go there. I see it moving. Wow, that was like 10 centimeters.
So these are 4 millimeter thick disc magnets. And they're really, really strong. And I put all the polarity in the same direction here, so like plus or minus is facing upwards. And I'm not sure that was the correct decision. I realized that if I put them in an alternating pattern, like plus and minus every other magnet, like turning every other magnet around, I had even more traction, even more magnetism. And we are experiencing some problems with the marbles becoming magnetized. And I'm not sure, yeah, that's a nice slow-mo magnet throw right there. So I'm not sure if I would have put the magnets in opposite polarity every other magnet, if that would have helped with the magnetization of the marbles or not. But we're working on solving that right now.
And all I'm thinking is world tour, world tour, world tour, world tour. Oh, these repetitive tasks drive you crazy in no time. You have to have a mantra, and I choose world tour, world tour, world. World tour, world tour. Look at this. It's magnetic. Well, it's magnet, so maybe I shouldn't be so. So, this makes me really happy. It's an object of beauty right now, actually. When I see this, it's actually a little bit of a shame that we're gonna cover it with the second piece. So, bye-bye.
So here I'm putting the two pieces temporarily attached to each other. I want to avoid using glue in this machine as much as possible because I would like to be able to take pieces apart and change them and repair them if needed. So I'm leveling and sturdying the metal base and attaching the gear with the bearing housings onto the frame.
Well, that is running quite true, I have to say. And also, I have to say, it runs quite silent. So this is the meshing gear, and this gear comes from the crank axis. And we also offset the tooth on this one. So we hope that this power transmission will be double smooth. I have no clue. What's gonna happen now? Yes! Did you see that? Oh, yes! Why is it so fun? Well, we're like on the first time in the project where we need to test roll a marble. Maybe that's what's so fun. Okay, did you see that? Here it's coming. I didn't see it, it's too fast. There it is. Yes! Okay, slower. What happened there? This now.
So in the real application, the marbles would get raked off at the top and they wouldn't come down again on the right side of the wheel.
This is the kind of marble tracks we're gonna weld for the whole machine. And when I see these materials, the untreated plywood,
the untreated steel and the untreated 5mm steel rod marble roller coaster track come together, it feels very, very promising. So I set up the camera for a slow-mo shoot. Let's see if we can slow it down and show you how this works. Somewhere up here we're gonna put a wedge into the groove and rake the marbles off the wheel, and they're gonna continue further up into the machine. For 1 second I thought I invented free energy, and then I remember that I believe in physics. So the marbles are going to enter down here, and they're gonna go this way, they're gonna go out up here. So we're gonna rake them off out of the marble crack there, then they're gonna go round like this, and then they're gonna come into a second lifting wheel here, which is placed inside a planetary gear inside the programming wheel. I'm gonna give you a cliffhanger on the programming wheel. Somewhere there. So, and the fun thing with this programming wheel is that there's no glue, no screws, nothing. It's just a perfect tolerances from the CNC machine that makes me able to make a puzzle like this and just hammer the pieces together, and we have a solid construction. It's really nice, they fit really nice together. The marbles enter down here and getting picked off here. Then they go around here and into the second marble ring lift wheel, will be inset inside the programming wheel. That will look really fantastic, because the programming wheel will spin in this direction, like this. And the inset planetary gear marble ring lift 2 will spin the opposite direction right next to it. So it will really look like a time machine clock kind of thing. Anyway, this is just a skeleton of the programming wheel, and it's a subject for another video. I just wanted to throw it in there to say thanks for watching to the end of this video, and thanks for watching in general. Take care, bye bye. So video Martin said bye bye, and voiceover Martin is still here apparently. It's so nice to have another part on the base. For every part we're putting on this machine, we're one step closer to the world tour. So the music is much more important than the machines, and the music is the end goal. The machine is not the end goal. I just want to put that out there again. So I just want to say here that no animals were harmed in the production of this video. Thanks again for watching, and next week we're gonna put another part on the marble machine to take us one step closer to the elusive future world tour. Okay, have a nice day everyone. Bye.